Holy crap, guys, it is 6 o'clock in the morning on Wednesday, August 14th. The world just freaking changed. Today is the day the 2-year and the 10-year treasury yield curve inverted. Insane, guys. Every single time this happens, the stock market crashes. It's terrible. This is insane. What I want to go through in this video is what the heck's going on, and then what you can do to keep your profits, keep your portfolio stable, and maintain profitability in the next 2 to 3 years as we look exponential and powerful indicator of a market reversal. If you guys saw, I already have made a video on the inverted yield curve talking about the insane danger of this tool in financial markets. But today is the day, after freaking the longest bull run in history, that this thing has come to fruition. Here's what I wanna do in this video. I wanna tell you what you can do to keep your portfolio afloat, what investments are gonna probably freaking explode in the next 2 years, what's gonna be risky, and where the heck you should be putting your money and have the maximum impact in your portfolio growth from this movement, okay? Sound awesome? Look, here's the deal. It's right here in the book, okay? Every single time there's an inverted yield, there's a freaking recession. This is like insane. The average number of months from the date of inversion to the date of recession starting is about 20 months. And the average gain of the S&P from the time of the inversion, which is today, to the time of the start of the recession is about 10%. So look, here's the deal. Markets aren't gonna go down immediately. They might freak out today, they might freak out over the next month. Statistically and historically, the market's still gonna go up for, like, you know, at a minimum, probably about 10 months. Lowest time period we see is 10 months in 1980 before the crash. Highest time period we see is about 35 months in 1998 from inversion of the yield curve to a massive freaking recession. So what's that mean? 1998, that was still before a massive, massive amount of growth in the stock market, especially in tech stocks, which means we can still see a massive, massive amount of growth in the next 1 to 2 years. But look, you guys gotta be freaking careful, because here's what's gonna happen. We are basically at the verge. You guys have seen my other video on it, and where I go a lot deeper into the historics and the extreme reliability of this indicator, and I'll link it below. The point is, when this happens, the world freaking ends. Here's what I'm worried about. The first thing I'm worried about is international debt, especially with Japan and China. Right now we got trade wars. Look, I could care less about trade wars. I'm more worried about the value of their currencies relative to international interest rates. You have Chinese bonds paying negative interest rates. Here's the deal. They have a freaking massive amount of sovereign debt because their individuals in those countries, specifically China and Japan, have a tremendous, their citizens, right, will loan the government money. Just like we loan the US government money through US treasuries, Chinese citizens loan the Chinese government. So they have a ton of debt. And because of that massive amount of debt, if the interest rates go up just a little bit, it's gonna freaking crush them because they aren't gonna be able to cover the interest expenses on this debt. I'm gonna link a video below that explains this concept a lot more in much more depth, about 10 minutes. It came out years and years and years ago, and it's got fundamental basis. So what does this mean? Well, what this means is, first of all, you're looking at an extremely high risk of credit default for the Japanese government. Freaking crazy stuff can happen. If global rates go up, right now we see stuff inverting, stuff's seriously messed up. We have short-term rates that are paying more than long-term rates, right? That's the principle of this inversion. And so because of that, if the economy goes upside down, these guys are gonna be the first out. We just saw the IMF bailout Argentina for a massive, massive amount of debt collapse and destruction. We might see that same thing happen. Again, this is gonna take a couple of years. This might not happen overnight, but this indicator is the indicator. You look at this book, Fake by Robert Kiyosaki, exact same freaking thing he's talking about is this terrible issue where these governments just keep printing and printing and printing money through these bonds that they're selling to the individuals in society. It's a serious freaking issue. So that's number one. Number one thing I'm super worried about is collapse of foreign debt. Number two thing, serious problem here is the US government. These rates go down, that means international investors investing in US treasuries are losing money fast. fast. These interest rates keep going down. It's gonna screw over these international governments, especially China, who's investing billions into the American economy through these treasury bonds. What's that mean? Well, the US government wants China to keep paying us money. They want debt. So what they've been doing, and what he talks about, Kiyosaki, is this, they're holding down gold, right? And they're selling a whole bunch of gold to China. So what's this gonna mean? We've seen it in the last couple months. Gold went from 1125, 1250 to freaking 1500 right now. Gold looks like it's gonna keep going up. You look at this in 08, everything before, in the next 2 to 3 to 4 years, gold is definitely about to freaking crush. You got international tensions, trade wars, all of these factors are gonna destabilize traditional currencies. The US dollar is at its strongest peak in the world right now, and it's going up and up and up. So if we see the dollar getting stronger, that's gonna hurt gold in the short term. It's also gonna destabilize these global economies, and specifically China and Japan. If they get weaker versus the US dollar, that's gonna crush their ability to leverage interest on their money. Okay, that's number two. Number two is gold. Gold, freaking, I would up that percentage in your portfolio. Keep it diversified, keep it safe, and keep it stable. But in a declining interest rate environment, and especially if we see what happened, just like in 08, where interest rates freaking hit zero, gold will probably crush it, right? So I'll keep that as a diversified position. Number three, this one's big. The idea of, if you're in real estate, right? If you're in real estate, you're looking at 30-year mortgages, especially fixed rate investments on homes that you're gonna be renting out. Right now, 30-year rates are lower than short-term rates, which means this is a prime time. But also means that if the economy takes a dump, you're gonna see lower and lower and lower interest rates, which means cheaper money to borrow from the banks, cheaper mortgages. So in the next 1 to 2 years, watch out for these housing, the housing market right now is not gonna be particularly impacted, but if the market crashes, everything will be impacted. It all will stem from this global economic shift. So watch for great deals, watch for your price. I know housing markets have been huge, very high price in the past couple of years. This could seriously affect that because money is about to get cheaper. And if money gets cheaper, it means you can get in those positions much better, leveraging the bank. Okay, two more things. Number four, banks. Guys, banks, if they are where they're at right now, and they're looking specifically at their ability to maintain reason in the marketplace. Look, they're on a leveraged financial system. This is everything Kiyosaki talks about, okay? The idea of the fractional reserve banking system, and specifically, like if I give a bank $10, they're gonna loan out $9. Next guy's gonna loan out $8.10. Basically, it makes about $100 of fake money for every 10 bucks I put in, 90 bucks fake money, okay? Fake money will get stretched out if this gets messed up. We're looking at interest rates declining. What's that mean? It means people are getting paid less money on a guaranteed basis. It means people are gonna be more risk centered. They were gonna put more cash in the stock market, especially the next 1 to 2 years. And you saw this happen in 1998, where rates went down, long-term rates went down, people had to turn to equities for investments. I'd also look at speculative bond markets. These things are about to explode, right? Because you don't have that safe baseline investment anymore. The only thing really that most of these very conservative investors are gonna have are tips, and those tips are paying like freaking 0.5% right now. And we're barely gonna see deflation. We saw like, 2.5% deflation in 08, and that was it. That was the only period of deflation in decades. So please focus on, I'm thinking gold as an investment, and I'm also thinking as active swing trades. Here's the deal, you can short a stock, all right? Number five, get technical analysis down. This is everything I teach in part 2 of 9 to noon. It's all based on this idea that you use technical setups, patterns, and indicators to find the right positions. I've been doing swing trades in the market right around now, and this volatility is amazing, especially for trading 9 to noon. This volatility is turning out massive profits and increasing the ability. If you guys saw over on my Facebook page, I'm putting out updates every single day of all these trades. Look, it all stems from your ability to identify trades. They're gonna work up or down, and then leveraging, you can leverage options, right? Talk about it in the book. Puts are gonna be huge in an economy like this, especially if you look at the next 1 to 2 years of finding that market top and then putting out like a 2-year put on it. That'd be huge. You don't really want to time the market. I'm looking more at individual stocks here. I think number five, where you want to be, is technical analysis of individual stocks for either the short term, medium term, or the next 5 years. Any of those three time periods should look amazing. I've seen this for a very long time with all the swing trades I've been doing. A vast majority of the stocks I'm trading right now and have been trading for the past year or two look like what they've looked like in 2008. Like, this is not surprise news. This is not a whole new idea. The big stocks have been crushing it, but a lot of these smaller companies have been dwindling away. Instance, Toll Brothers, Campbell Soup, these are two companies I've been trading and made positions on in the past 1 or 2 years, and they have been freaking down and down and down and down. New L Brands, they took the biggest freaking crash. They went from like $60 to $15. There are stocks that are crashing. This has been happening for years already. This is nothing new, but we're now starting to see it translate into those international interest rates, and that's going to affect foreign affairs. It's going to affect global currencies. It's going to affect the price of gold. It's going to affect perception of value. And a little bit of a bonus thing at the end here. We've seen it already. Bitcoin's gone from $3,000 to $12,000 in the past freaking like 6 months. This is going to affect crypto as much as it affects gold, if not more. We're going to see the people's currency start to evolve. We're going to see the further development of investments in blockchain technologies, and specifically speculative asset investments in cryptocurrencies, from people that are trying to draw their money out of traditional assets and equities and bonds and put it into riskier investments, just like what happened in 1998. This could seriously trump, you know, we've already seen it happen. Bitcoin's freaking tripled. That's an index for the overarching crypto market. What I'm looking more at here is using technical analysis of individual smaller cryptocurrencies and having swing trades on those positions. I'll flash up some images here. These are all cryptos that have been absolutely freaking crushing it based currently on the volatility of international equities, international exchange rates, and fear of debt crises. Look, you guys have seen, I'll link it below, Ray Dalio's big debt crisis. What we're looking at here is basically approaching the peak of a global big debt crisis, and how we approach that is gonna fundamentally shift how we look at the global markets in the next 1 to 2 years. This is a serious problem, guys. Today is a day that will be marked in history, and it's just a matter of time until we do see that market correction, until we see that massive reversal. I want you guys to make money from it. I want you guys to make a ridiculous amount of money from it. Right now, if you look at international insurance contracts, especially on the Japanese government, they're trading for 0.003 pennies on $100. You know, it's crazy. You can get a lot of money made in the next couple of years, and it all stems from your ability to freaking look at these global markets and make it work. This indicator, this inverted yield curve, is going to change how people perceive markets, and it's also going to be the ultimate indicator that we are very, very close to this market peak. And look, guys, it shouldn't come to a surprise to you. The freaking world's been talking about this for years and years and years and years. I mean, I wrote this book on personal finance and investing on like how to make a bunch of money in stocks. Like, I published it at the peak of the market, right? Because that's where I've been making all my money, is as the market goes up and up and up and up. It's not a surprise. This happens. It's a cyclical economy. Your goal here is to turn this downside into profit, okay? Thank you guys so much. Please check out those resources below. They are absolute freaking gold. And I'll get that book review done for Kiyosaki. And definitely, definitely grab your copy at 9 to noon. Go out there. Use technical analysis. These two words freaking changed my life, because they allow you to find high probability setups that freaking crush it. So you can have an 85% plus win percentage and crush your investments, especially in times of increased volatility. Thank you guys so much. Please, please, please share this video with anyone you know that has any assets in the economy, because we're gonna start to see index funds start to crash in the next 1 to 2 years. It's gonna be a freaking problem as we enter a recession, which sucks. You wanna make sure that you're in the right assets. A 60-40 split on your portfolio is not good enough, all right? Bonds are highly correlated to stocks. This is all I talk about in chapter 35. It's this idea that you are not safe if you have bonds, right? It's not enough. Look at the dream portfolio. Look at investing more in gold, right? And understanding where your assets are and the volatility of each asset based on the market, because the market is peaking. It's going, it's coming. Might be a couple years, but we're looking at a top inbound, and you wanna make sure that you're not over-reliant on the volatility of the stock market. This is huge stuff. There are so many concepts in this video. Everything here stems from your ability to take this, freaking apply it, okay? All the resources are here for you. Everything I do on this channel and what I do through 9 to noon and all the education is all based on this. I'm working right now on a course, but I just had to freaking take a break this morning because I got a notification on my phone that the freaking yield curve inverted. This is game changing. This is a day for history. Do a good job, stick with it, get the education you need to make profits while everybody else loses their shirt. Thanks guys so much. Have an amazing, amazing day. And have an amazing, amazing next 2 to 3 years of investments. Thank you guys. Bye. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to learn more about personal finance and investing. All that great stuff. That's what I'm so passionate about. So awesome. So yeah, crush it.